Well, folks, good morning.
Good morning.
It is Palm Sunday, and we say Hosanna.
Hosanna.
Blessed is the one who comes.
In the name of the Lord.
Very good. You all know. It is good to be together on this beautiful Sunday morning. And I kind of suspected after the funeral yesterday that we would not have a huge attendance today. And that does sometimes happen when we have a big memorial service or funeral. But we are glad to be who we are this morning and to celebrate this blessed Palm Sunday. So welcome to worship. I'm so glad you are here. If it is your first time with us, we welcome you. And I'm going to invite Faye forward to bring us our announcements. That mic isn't picking up.
Well, good morning, everybody. We had totally expected to have a procession into the church this morning with our palms, but they had blown us right out the side door. So welcome to this beautiful, beautiful Sunday with a little breeze going. And I do have quite a list to go. And the first thing is, and in your pews, there's a red registration book. Would you please be sure to pick that up and send it down the aisle? Sign in, and then if you're not sure who's in the row with you, you can peek at the book. You'll find their name there, hopefully. And then if you have a cell phone, please be sure that it's turned off for worship this morning on this beautiful Palm Sunday. I wanted to update you on our work last week towards helping UMCOR do service in the Ukraine. United Methodists across the globe are condemning the Russian invasion of Ukraine. As Christians, we believe that war is incompatible with the teachings and example of Christ. We therefore reject war as an instrument of national foreign policy. And that comes from the Methodist Book of Discipline, Social Principles. And we also know that our God stands with the oppressed and calls on us to support them. So two Sundays ago was UMCOR Sunday, the Sunday where all the contributions to UMCOR went towards the administrative costs. And that Sunday, we contributed $294. And last Sunday, we started our collection for the actual work on the ground, the boots on the ground, the folks that represent us and work with us and for us. And so far, and we're hoping to add to it today, if you have, you're so inclined, make sure to mark your check UMCOR or Ukraine on it, and it will go to the correct place. We have collected $2,375 so far. So anything today will add to that. And across the United States, Methodists have been collecting millions of dollars. And so this contribution will certainly help with that. Thank you for doing that. Today is another really cool thing happening over in the fireside room. It's the soft opening of the church pictorial directory. You are going to be in it. Yeah. Felicia and Peggy are heading up that operation. Raise your hands, ladies. There they are. They're in maroon today. And that Felicia has brought along her parents today, who are going to help them out. And her dad has some professional photographic equipment set up over there so that our backgrounds are almost going to look the same. Some people are out in the world and we have to get a picture from them some other way. But Dave Cole is going to be taking pictures. So you can start today, the soft opening, and they'll be there next Sunday and the Sunday after. And go in and get your picture taken. Everybody, if you're camera shy and you're just not going to do it, we still need you to go and check the information that they have written about you. Your name, your address, your email, your telephone numbers. And then there's some permission that you sign for it to be in the directory. One thing about this, well, there's many wonderful things about this directory. It's going to be digital. It can be printed out. It's going to be accessible to you online. So it's something that we need to be aware of as a community, that it's within us, within our perusal, and not to be spread out when your relative or my relative starts a business. We don't give out that directory. So just, you know, be aware of that ahead of time. And so there are some protections that go with it and codes to get into it. So some people are just really a little bit shy of doing something like that. And so be assured that Felicia and Peggy are going to be watching over us all and our information down that information highway. So today, Sunday. Palm Sunday. We are going to have refreshments afterwards in the hall, so come on over. Some fresh, some left from yesterday, which is pretty fresh.
Pretty fresh.
Pretty fresh and delicious. Yes, and then of course in the fireside room, the directory will be going on, and the finance committee is going to meet somewhere, and we won't go into the fireside room. We'll find a spot to go after worship today. And also, if you brought your Easter candy to put into the eggs, there's a basket over there to put that in, your toys or Easter candy. We really appreciate that. On Wednesday at 5 o'clock, Carol and Don are going to be stuffing the eggs. And so if you didn't get it here and you really want to get it there, you could come over at 5 o'clock and drop it off and or call ahead and see if someone might be here, because Elizabeth and Jacob may be here quite a bit this week preparing for Easter, just to drop them off. Tomorrow is our Zoom Bible study at 4 o'clock on the book of Isaiah. Tuesday, take a lot of deep breaths and relax. And Wednesday, you can join in the social hour. And if you'd like to help them with the eggs, you could come over at 5 o'clock. On Thursday, is probably one of the most meaningful days of this Holy Week that's coming up. It's Maundy Thursday, and there's a service at 7 o'clock where there will be foot and hand washing and Holy Communion celebrated right here in our chapel. And then Friday at 12 o'clock, Good Friday at 12 will be at St. Mark's United Methodist Church. And if you need the address for that, you can get it online or ask one of us and we'll get it to you. And come and join. There'll be a circuit choir singing there, and also a beautiful service with all the other churches in our circuit. Some people work through Good Friday now. When I was a child, the banks were closed. You remember that? And there was almost a global look at Good Friday, and things have changed all, you know, through time. So if you can make it there, it would be great. So next Sunday is our biggest Sunday of the year, Easter Sunday. We can fill your day. We're going to serve a meal of pancake breakfast between 7:30 and 9:30. And if you run in at 9:40, we'll probably still have some left. But you got to get in here by 10. And then an Easter sunrise service out by the fire pit at 6:45 a.m. And then breakfast after that, if you like. Come for one, come for two, come for all, everybody. And it'll be a free will donation for the pancake breakfast. And the Kirkuses and the Hasses are sponsoring hosting that day. So come on over. We'd love to have you.
We're cooking.
We're cooking. We're cooking and smiling and serving and getting up early. Bring along I don't know about you, but my roses are spectacular right now. Bring along your cut flowers next week to make an Easter cross out in front. Cut flowers. Also, if you'd like to bring a plant this week for Easter, it'd be good to bring it again when someone's here if you didn't bring it today. And I left mine right behind the garage door. I could get those over here. So, and there's a sign-up sheet outside to dedicate your flowers for next week. Alrighty, so our finance committee today is going to be talking about upcoming things, and This week I had Jacob send you an in-the-know email and listed almost all of these things so you can look back at it. And if you don't get email, there's one printed over there in Adams Hall. But we will be having the Sunday after Easter, you can come for another meal after church. We're the finance committee sponsoring a bake sale. Of course, we're not doing all the baking. We need your help, you bakers out there, to bring something for the bake sale. And also, we're going to have a hot dog and hamburger barbecue that day. And we would love for you to join us. If you're used to going out with your friends after church, maybe in 2 weeks, let's all, we are used to going out, to stay here and have our lunch together for some help with the finance committee. This week, Joe gave us these affirmations, and they came from the Iona community. And it's an international ecumenical Christian movement for justice and peace. She was a little worried that they were long for me to read, but I think I can do it. We believe that God is present in the darkness before dawn, in the waiting and uncertainty where fear and courage join hands. Conflict and caring link arms, and the sun rises over barbed wire. The second one, we believe in a with us God who sits down in our midst to share our humanity. We affirm a faith that takes us beyond the safe place into action, into vulnerability, and into the streets. And the last one, we commit ourselves to work for change and put us on the line, to bear responsibility, to take risks, live powerfully, and face humiliation, to stand with those on the edge, to choose life and be used by the Spirit for God's new community of hope. Those are powerful words. In your celebrations this week, 4 birthdays among us and an anniversary. And 2 of our birthday people are here today. Tomorrow, Lorraine celebrates her birthday. Happy birthday, Lorraine. And Wednesday, Ken Crawford celebrates his birthday. I can't see your faces with these glasses on, so Ken is out there. Lorraine's pretty cool. There he is back there. You're way back. Happy birthday to you, Ken. On Thursday, the Haas clan is going to be celebrating the patriarch's birthday. Tom Haas celebrates his birthday on Thursday. And another person out there in their neighborhood is Karen Burr, and she celebrates her birthday on Thursday as well. And that same day, John and Ann Simmons are celebrating 37 years of marriage. So that's quite a day on Thursday, the 14th. Okay, I'm looking here now. Before I turn it over, then I get it all. And of course, the other thing for Lorraine, too, are gift cards that you could give to Mike and Lorraine for our May fundraiser, if you have some hanging around. And they'll take those very willingly. Okie dokie. Pantry. Next Sunday, Easter, some of us are staying here all day to receive your gifts for the People's Pantry. It is drop-off zone day. We need jelly. We need one-can meals like Chef Boyardee. Cups of noodles, I never see them on the shelves right now, but if you do, pick up some for us. A few more cake mixes, and then, of course, our bread and eggs that we get each month. When you go home, think about this. Plant your spring garden. Plant your spring garden. Plant your spring garden. I typed the wrong word in here. It's plant your spring peas. Peace of mind, peace of heart, peace of soul, and three rows of squash. Squash indifference, squash hatred, squash bullying, and 3 rows of lettuce. Let us be kind, let us be compassionate, let us love one another, And above all, water with patience and cultivate with love in this Holy Week. Enjoy.
All right. Good morning, everyone. Please rise if you are able. Make sure you have your palms in hand to wave. Join me with Hosanna, loud Hosanna.
The abandoned and the oppressed.
We shout for joy at Christ's coming.
We have laid down our cloaks and watch as God draws near, riding in triumph toward the cross.
Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Today, friends, we invite Jesus to come into our lives more deeply during this Holy Week, rejoicing that he welcomes all to follow him.
May we allow him to draw near.
May we take up our cross to follow him.
May we be renewed in the hopes of his eternal triumph. Amen.
Welcome the start of the worship throng. Water
Stephanie. Hallelujah, children. You made it. It's good to see you, Nate. All right, this is a Palm Sunday tradition, and I just want to put out there that whatever mistakes are made during this time, God is a God of grace and love. So today we are going to tell the Palm Sunday story, and we're going to use some little indicators that we will make as I tell the story. So I'm going to be a conductor, but first, before we do this, I need, Nathaniel, can you hand this to Rayanne? Do you see where she's sitting? Rayanne, can you wave? That's number one. Okay, number ones, you are going to be Rayanne to the back of the church, and I'm going to teach you what you're going to do whenever you hear the word Friends of Jesus. Anytime you hear the word Friends of Jesus,
sorry,
I don't know what's going on with my microphone. You are going to sing, Jesus loves me, this I know. Just that part. You ready?
Jesus loves me, this I know.
Now that was very good, but that was all of you. Rayanne,
to the back, on the right side,
is what I'm aiming for. So let's hear it from that little tiny group, because you're all going to have a part, everybody. Okay? So Rayanne, will you just put your hand up and say, Jesus, don't even open that paper.
Jesus loves me, this I know.
Okay, Friends of Jesus, let's hear you. Oh my goodness, this is a lot harder than I expected. Okay, all right, everybody. This group of people here is going to sing just the first line of Jesus Loves Me, this I know. Jesus loves me, this I know. Very good. And when I point that out to you, you don't need that. You just need this. This is the one. Anytime I point to the one, you're going to sing,
Jesus loves me, this I know.
Okay. Okay, number twos, we're going to be, you're going to be twos. Okay. Kimberly, you hold this, okay. And anytime I see that two, you're going to say, you're going to be the crowd, and you're going to say, Hosanna, 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 and you include right here. So this group, and you need to be loud about it.
Okay.
Okay? So anytime I say the word crowd,
Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna. Hosanna.
Perfect. Threes right here, and you are going to be the threes that go from here to here,
okay.
And the threes are the palms. You get to be palms, and this is my favorite part, everybody. They get to say, swish, swish, swish. Very good. Okay, fours, are you guys ready for this? You get to hold the four. Whatever's on the inside of the paper, just ignore it. I don't know what it is. Okay. And you guys get to be the donkey. Oh! And you get to say clip clop, clip clop, clip clop. Are you ready? Clop, clip clop, clip clop. Okay. Now fives.
I think we won now.
I'm gonna give the children the fives. You guys are gonna be the whole city. Okay. All you have to say is hubbub, hubbub, hubbub. Can you do it? Yeah, just like that. Hubbub, hubbub, hubbub. Do whatever you want. Make the noise.
Hubbub.
Yeah, thank you. Can you do it with me? Hubbub, hubbub, hubbub. And sixes, I hate to do this to you, but you're the enemies of Jesus. Oh. I know, right? And you, I know, right? I'm grinning. And you have to say mutter, mutter, mutter. And that includes everyone from here. I'm so sorry. Oh, you're huge. You're terrible. Okay. Mutter, mutter, mutter. Very good. Okay. Do you get the idea? Good. Do you use your music stand? No, I'm not. Thank you. I should have asked for that earlier. All right. Friends. What do the friends of Jesus say?
Jesus loves me, this I know.
I just love how you all want to sing that. That's awesome. All right. One day while Jesus was in Bethphage near the Mount of Olives, he turned to his friends.
Jesus loves me, this I know.
His disciples. disciples, and he said to them, "It is time to go to Jerusalem." But Jesus, they replied, "If you enter that city, your enemies will try to kill you." Jesus had made up his mind, however, and he gave directions to two of the disciples to go into the village and obtain a donkey. Very good for him to ride. So off went the disciples in the village. In the village, they found the animal tied, and when they began to untie it, the owner said, "What are you doing?" And the disciples answered, "My friend,
Jesus loves me this time.
Jesus, my friend Jesus has need of it, and he will return it to you." Soon the disciples came back to Jesus, and bleeding the donkey, which no one had ever ridden. Quickly, Jesus' followers put some of their clothes upon the little animal's back, and then Jesus climbed on. All set off toward the city. Oh, this happens every year. I can't find it. Okay. Sorry, you guys. And Jesus rode along on the donkey. And people came out to welcome him with shouts and waves. A noisy crowd.
Hosanna! Hosanna! Hosanna!
Lined the road, and some of them tore down branches of palms.
Swish, 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 swish.
To lay before the donkey. As it passed, "Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord," they shouted. The crowd.
Hosanna!
Hosanna! Hosanna!
Followed Jesus and waved palms.
Swish, 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 swish.
As he traveled toward the city, where, city? Where he would spend one final week with his friends.
Jesus loves me this time, oh.
And where he would die at the hands of his enemies. Friends, thank you for helping me to tell the story. Good job. Story. Yeah. So let's say a quick prayer, guys, before you go back to your seats. Thank you for helping us to tell your story, O God, and for showing us the way to the city that Jesus took. We ask your blessing today as we continue this service of worship. May we open our hearts to your love and your care in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
And if whatever you have on the inside of your sheet, that's all scratch paper, so throw it away, or if it's part of a poem, read it. It's a lot of scratch paper. So.
Please join me with the Lamb of God.
No sin to hide, but you have said.
enjoy today, and that's the directory, of course. Alicia and I are starting that in the fireside room, and I'd like to shout out a special thanks to Bill, her, Alicia's dad, for letting us use his professional. I had the vision, you know, smartphones and outside, so this is a real step up, so it's a big joy. So, prayers of the people. Mike Salmon is requesting prayers for Joyce, that the doctors find out what is wrong with her. Oh Lord, hear our prayers. Prayers for Lodgy's son, he has COVID. Oh Lord,
hear our prayers.
Georgia Hott's son John is in Mercy Folsom with kidney stones. Prayers for healing and relief of pain. Oh Lord,
hear our prayers.
Bob Hott is having a hernia surgery on this coming Friday, April 15th. Prayers for a successful surgery and healing. Oh Lord,
hear our prayers.
Prayers for David Dunlap during his ongoing radiation treatment for 5 days a week for 5 weeks. Oh Lord,
hear our prayers.
I haven't heard the status of Sam, our young man that has kidney cancer, but I think he had surgery this last week. So let's just keep praying for Sam and his mom. Oh Lord,
hear our prayers.
Prayers for our church as we prepare for Holy Week. Oh Lord,
hear our prayers.
Prayers for pastors, worship teams, and all those involved with Holy Week services and activities. Oh Lord,
hear our prayers.
Prayers for Ukraine and the world as we live with this ongoing war and daily news of the atrocities inflicted on the Ukrainian people. Oh Lord,
hear our prayers.
Please join me in praying the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Please join me in the invitation to the offering. All that we have,
all that we are, all that we hope to be, we give to you, Lord of life. Amen.
Changed, yes, really changed. In these past
To Jerusalem. When he had come near Bethphage and Bethany at the place called the Mount of Olives, he sent two of the disciples, saying, "Go into the village ahead of you, and as you enter it, you will find tied there a colt that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone asks you, 'Why are you untying it?' just say this, 'The Lord needs it.'" So those who were sent departed and found it as he had told them. As they were untying the colt, its owners asked them, "Why are you untying the colt?" They said, "The Lord needs it." Then they brought it to Jesus, and after throwing their cloaks on the colt, they set Jesus on it. As they rode along, people kept spreading their cloaks on the road. As he was now approaching the path down from the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of the disciples began to praise God joyfully with a loud voice for all the deeds of power that they had seen, saying, "Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest heaven." Some of the Pharisees in the crowd said to him, "Teacher, order your disciples to stop." He answered, "I tell you, if these were silent, the stones would shout out." Words of God, words of life.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Please join me in the spirit of prayer. Good and gracious God, thank you for this story. The story that brings us into the city, but also walks us to the foot of the cross. Help us to be mindful of Jesus, our Savior, of his humanity, of this experience. I ask now that the words of my mouth and the meditations of all of our hearts be acceptable in your sight. I lift this prayer in Jesus' strong and loving name. Amen. Well, I want you to get out your palms for a minute. And I want us to think about the word Hosanna. So let's just wave these palms and shout out a little Hosanna. Hosanna!
Hosanna!
Hosanna. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the house. Good job. When you wave these palms and you think of those words, what do you think that word means? And if you read it and you knew it already, you can tell us. But what do you think the word Hosanna means?
Praise.
Praise, sure. You think it means praise. That's what I thought it meant too when I first started doing this work. Hosanna means save us. Who said that? Somebody new, right? It means save us. We pray that you will save us. So when we think about this parade that we celebrate on this beautiful day wearing our nicest clothes and imagining sort of these nice store-bought palms and what they mean, we think of sort of like what you would do on the 4th of July or in a festive situation, don't we? You know, maybe the Macy's Thanksgiving Day parade. That is not what this parade is all about, right? It just isn't. This parade is a story of a people who are crying out to be saved. Some of those people, maybe some widows whose husbands were executed by the Romans, the people who would eventually nail Jesus to the cross, right? Maybe they are some of the people that Jesus healed who have lived their entire lives on the margins because of their disabilities and their illnesses. Maybe they were some of the people who were living in abject poverty because there was not enough resource to go around. These are people who feel a deep-rooted hunger for salvation. Amen. And so when we see this journey, and we imagine that road strewn with, it doesn't say palm branches, it really just says the branches of trees, and people's sweaters and cloaks. Sometimes maybe that was the only garment they had to keep themselves warm. A cloak is a powerful thing. Laid out so that a donkey with the Son of Man can enter the city with the recognition that they felt he deserved. Now, friends, the kind of recognition that a real king would have received at that time would have looked more like a gold-lined road, right? And the feast and the people would have been in their very best clothes and dressed in all of their finery, right? But what is happening here is almost, I'm not even going to say is subversive. Because a real king, a king of the world, would have come in on a whole big horse, right? On a steed prancing into the city. This is God's king, though, and he comes into the world, into the community, and to the people in a different way. He is the kind of king that makes the worldly kings uncomfortable. Amen? Because the crowd knows who to ask for salvation. Amen? People who live in their mighty palaces and who rule from their mighty thrones, they thrive on people's neediness and hunger. They want to hear the cry of the community to be saved by the government, to be saved by the powerful and the rich. But it's so interesting about how crowd knows and sees where salvation can really come from. They have seen the integrity of Jesus walking among the people, healing the sick, teaching the people in the temple. They have seen him eat meals with sinners and other, well, just humans like us, sinners, right? They see it and they know it and they've heard about it and they respect it. And when he comes into the city to face the end of his life, they know to yell out, "Save us. Save us." Now this crowd is as fickle as any crowd is, amen? Because this is the same crowd, the hubbub group. It's the hubbub, hubbub, hubbub is going to become the mutter, 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 right? Because in just a few days, they are going to be shouting out, crucify him. Crucify him. They're going to pick Barabbas and not Jesus to be saved. It's complicated, people. But we know that on Maundy Thursday, we call it Maundy Thursday because of the mandate to love one another. That's the Maundy Mandatum. We know that Judas sat at that table too, and that Jesus welcomed him as well. This is a powerful, powerful week in the Christian church. This is a journey that we have the opportunity to make, to walk in solidarity with Jesus, because he chose and chooses still to walk in solidarity with those who suffer, with those who hurt, with those who are on the margins, with those who are hungry, with those who live without a home around them or a roof over their heads. We have the opportunity as Christians to walk this journey with him. And I pray that we will. That we will see the ones who he saw yelling the words, save us, save us, save us. And some days we are those people too. We sit with some pretty good, comfortable privilege here, right? But some days we ourselves also need that level saving, right? That level. We always need Jesus, amen? But sometimes we need that rescue that is bigger than a small request in a prayerful closet. This week is that week in the church year. But the truth of the matter is every week is actually that week. But this is the week when we get to walk the journey and see where he's been and see where he's going and take ourselves into that upper room and celebrate the last meal he will share with his disciples and be present at the cross, in the Garden of Gethsemane, and then at the cross. And if we make this journey well together, the gift of the resurrection on Easter Sunday is a whole other story. Because we have seen the pain and the suffering. And we have chosen to wait it out like the women did at the foot of the cross, so that the glory of the resurrection can shine in our lives and in our world. So I hope you'll come along with us on Thursday and on Friday, and then close your heart, or open your heart, I don't know what it is exactly, on Saturday, where it is silent and Jesus is dead, so that when he rises from the dead on Sunday, you can open your heart with crazy joy for the gift of resurrection and the fact that death is defeated in Jesus the Christ. Amen.
What are we finishing with?
Mighty to save. Please rise if
Perfect.
You are able.
It's right.
Oh,
place, I pray that we will be ready to walk the journey that Jesus invites us into this week. So go in peace, knowing that the love of God surrounds us now and always, knowing that Jesus is our Christ, our Savior, but also our friend and our teacher. And may you know that the Holy Spirit is here, dwelling deep within you and all around each and every one of us, guiding us and guarding us and sustaining us until we are ready to do a new thing, and then it will inspire us to. Amen.